Hey family, Wagwan, what is up you guys? So today I'm gonna tell you how to get the woman of your dreams.
Boom, let's get it.
The bandits on the rise. The panic stay up on your TV. Turn up the volume and put it in a 3D. Yeah, yeah. Gather round, can you see me? Come back, we have a good time and be free. Sing it again. The panic stay up on your TV. Turn up the volume and put it in a 3D. Gather round, can you see me? Come back, we have a good time and be free. Me talk about everything where you gone. From personal life to politician. Full time, ain't that how we plan. We have to talk about food as a Jamaican. Yeah. The bonics on the rise.
Hey family, welcome back to the channel. Before we get into the video, go ahead, hit the like button, and if you have not subscribed to our channel, hit the subscribe button and become a part of the Bonics family. So in this video, Kemar is going to tell you how to seduce a woman, because a lot of you have asked Kemar, how did you snag your woman? How did you snag such a great, excellent, awesome woman of God, just like so prestigious? How in the world did you get her?
All right.
So today he is going to tell you how to get a Tanya in your life.
So I got 9 tips, starting with number one.
Number one.
So my first one on the list is your appearance. You see me? You want to appear, say you're going to meet you at Tanya. You want to appear clean and fresh. Personal hygiene, you see it, baby? Mm-hmm. So you have to brush your teeth, then you can't go with a smelling bad breath, so you go meet a Catania, right? You have to put on good cologne. You know what I say? Nice, put on something nice, show up. You want, when a Catania see you show up looking smart. You know what I mean? You don't want a Catania have to talk to you. If you see that you're smart, you're showing up looking smart and confident.
Yes.
So as a Catania, look at you, she know that, wow, that is the man. You know what I say?
Because a woman loves an intelligent man. A woman loves a clean, fresh man.
Yeah, man.
And a first impression is a last impression. So if you step into somebody and she's a mature woman, you got to step correct.
All right, then, baby. So you don't know. That was number one. So we're moving on again. Number two, a gentleman.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, you have to learn how to be a gentleman. Because a lot of people nowadays, you know, feel like being a gentleman, you know, Catania, is outdated, you know.
Mm-hmm.
But it's not. Being a gentleman is something good. It will actually blow all your woman mind. You know what I mean? Like, basically, You do things fear. You see me? I say, like, say for instance, you always have to try your best to remember. Say, alright. Say for instance, you and I even go to a restaurant or something.
Mm-hmm.
You then pull out the chair for her. You know what I say? And you have to be careful how you treat people around her as well.
Yes.
Because She look on everything, and not just she going to be a gentleman to and treat her nice.
Yes.
You see what I say? And then again, to say for instance, you and your lady a walk, you always have to try your best for remember family, and you walking, you always want to put her in the inner, like you're there on the street, you want to put her on the inner side, and you walk in the road, so the car can lick you down.
Yes, and sometimes you gotta show people how to,
like,
treat you.
Well, on the baby, like, you really say yes, like, me must walk in a road for you can't lick me. Me can't believe it.
No,
but all right, baby. Katanya said, me must walk in the road and dead so she can't live. But me, I go dead for you, Katanya.
I'm saying yes, like you gotta let the lady walk on the inside.
Yes, because... me, we catch a grenade for you, Katanya.
Okay, all right.
Yeah,
I'm just saying, like, you know, you gotta show up for your woman.
Yeah,
because
man.
A woman wants to feel safe and protected. And sometimes you gotta show people, like, how to treat you. So this is a good tip for you gentlemen, you men out there, that treat your woman like a gentleman. Because Kimar didn't always walk on the outside of the street. Sometimes I had to, like, tell him, like, you really gonna let me walk on the outside?
Yeah, man.
You know? So, So a woman wants to feel safe. And that was one of the things that kind of, like, got me when I met you. So it's kind of like how you get somebody, that's what you got to do to keep them.
Yeah,
so
man,
you made me feel
always hold your hand, man. Always,
yeah, you made me feel safe whenever I came to Jamaica. Yeah, and so now that we're in America, it's like you got to keep that going, you know?
Yeah, man, baby. So, yeah, man, family, moving on. What were they? Number three? We just come from number few. Number three, Katanya.
Yeah, that number few.
Yeah,
two.
Man. Number three is being a good listener.
Mm-hmm.
So, look here. You can't, like, say you want her go out and boom, she attack. When she's talking, you just relax and listen her.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, listen the conversation. And you have to pick. So, you know, talk, you know, mostly when she attack, you're being a listener.
Mm-hmm.
And then you pick valid point out of the conversation, and you can also ask question.
Why are you making it seem like you strategic?
Yeah, man, you can ask, pick valid, because when you're a listener, you know, and then she say, yeah, pick valid point out of the conversation, and then you ask her back question. Woman love them thing there. So, yeah, you have to be a good
because a woman like me
listener.
Got a lot to say.
Yeah.
So you got to hear what I'm saying.
Yeah, man. So,
yes.
That is it, man. You have to be a good listener.
Yes.
When you're on the woman on the date, you do less talking and make sure you do most of the talking.
Yes.
You will be the listener,
less
all right?
Less talking for you,
more talking
listening.
For yeah,
yes.
And more talking for the lady.
Mm-hmm.
So, that was number three. So, what we do? We're moving on again?
Yep. So, number four.
Yeah, man. Number 14, you know, man. So watch out, man, we're there, number four. So number four is what? High contact, man. So you see that? High contact, family. So look here now. You have to have a good eye contact. What you say? You want to elaborate on the one, Katanya?
Yeah, like when you're talking to anybody.
Yeah.
Like, you know, when you look somebody in the eye, like it's a sign of like being genuine, you know? Being transparent, being like honest. So a lot of times when people are telling a lie, they will kind of look away.
Yeah.
So it's just to make that person feel like more comfortable. It lets me know like you're on the up and up if you can kind of give me that eye contact. You know what I mean?
Yeah, man. I feel like say when you look her in her eye, that help her if it makes you feel more safe. What you feel like?
'Cause you look into my soul.
Yeah, man. She that help her if it makes you feel more love and feel more
mm-hmm.
confident in you
mm-hmm.
as a man.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, yeah, man, eye contact is very good
mm-hmm.
as a man. You have to practice eye contact. You have to carry your A game, you know, when it comes to eye contact, you know.
You gotta carry your A game,
Katanya. When it comes to eye contact, maybe.
Oh my God, you so dramatic.
Yeah, man.
Say it one more time.
A game, baby. And every A game, you have to carry your A game,
yeah,
you know, man. So, another one, number five, we're moving on, baby. No joke. Number five, a similarity.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. So, most man look over them thing. They like if them and a girl. Say you date somebody or you try to get to know them babes.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Similarity, some people might look over it, but you know, just it's not a look over like that. Like women love to feel more, like they feel more comfortable and connect when they feel like you and them have similarities,
yes.
And things in
something
like
in common.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
So for instance, you guys used to go to the same primary school or something, mm-hmm. yeah, have a conversation. It good for reminder of that. Or if you and I used to live in a same neighborhood, mm-hmm. it good for reminder mm-hmm. about them thing there, you know? Similarity, you know what I mean?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Similarity, yeah. You call that. So you want, guys, you want to mention them thing there when you and I are talk, you know what I mean?
Yeah, kind of like the same, like morals and values. And so, yeah, you just want to know, like, you got something in common with that person that's going to help you build the foundation. So, all
right. So, yeah, man, that was similarity. So, we're moving on again. So, number six, what do you know? So, number six is a what that open up to your woman. Yeah, man. So, number six, open up to your woman. So, you know, we as man, we're more.
It's a big one.
Masculine, right? We don't like.
It's a big one, pay attention,
like,
guys.
Yeah, we don't like feel kind of what you don't call, like soft, baby.
Mm-hmm.
Or,
yeah,
like kind of.
Vulnerable.
And, yeah, man don't like to feel so, but woman, your woman like when you open up to her, you know what I mean? I say, and show her certain things. Like, for instance, you go try to make you feel special and try to say, baby, you know me, I say,
mm-hmm.
like, me have a secret.
Mm-hmm.
And me I go tell you a secret that me never tell nobody yet.
Right.
And you tell her your secret, you know, say, Katani, you know, say, me love you, though, baby.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Mm-hmm.
So, she go feel more special because she say, what? You tell her something where you not tell nobody. You see me, I say?
Yeah.
Yeah, man. So, open up, you have to open up to your woman, man, and them thing
yeah.
there.
You gotta isn't open it? Your heart. You gotta be vulnerable because that's how women are. Like, we're emotional beings. And so we want to know, like, your inner thoughts, you know?
Yeah, man.
And sometimes, you know, and it really, like, it's a cultural difference, too, because, you know, in Jamaica, you don't grow so. You know, you don't grow like that, but you have come around to where, you know, I say, Kimar, like, this me. I'm your wife.
Yeah, man.
You know you can talk to me, and whatever you have to tell me is between me and you. And so I think that you have done a good job with opening up.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So you see them love when you open up to them. Man, you better open up and tap lock up. So,
for real.
So we're moving on again. You see me, I say, number seven.
Mm-hmm.
You have to have a great sense of humor.
Yes.
So when you say a great sense of humor again, in a day one, you have to bring your ear game again. Remember that. Great sense of humor. You see how this is a great sense of humor. You see how me I make she laugh? Sense, great sense of humor. You have to be able to make one woman can laugh
mm-hmm.
and forget about our struggles, them and
yes.
our pain. Free
yes.
our mind. You know what I say?
Yes.
So, sense of humor, as I tell you, say, yeah, man, ear game you have to bring upon
yes.
that. So, I don't know if you have nothing where you want to elaborate upon that, baby.
Yes.
Great
laughter
sense of humor.
Laughter is good for the soul.
Yeah,
so,
man.
You know, I done experienced a little bit more life than Kimar. And so, you know, you go through things and you have struggles and you have things upon your head and, you know, stresses and then, like, just work and
mm-hmm.
family and disagreements with friends, disagreements in your relationships. And laughter is good for the soul. You need somebody that at the end of the day, they can make you laugh.
Yeah, man.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, man. That's our number seven. So,
mm-hmm.
we're moving on again, family. So, number eight, family. The eighth question we had, you know, try to touch her, not in a sexual way. So, you have to try. Number eight is you have to try to touch her, but not in a sexual way. You see me? I say, like, for instance, yeah, try to know somebody, you have to break the untouchable band.
Mm-hmm.
Because when you just get to know, like, a date, people, you know, you have to kind of touch her. You have to break the untouchable band. So, like, say she do something great. You know what I say? You can give her a little fist bump, man, baby. Fist bump.
Ouch.
You know what
I mean? Not like that.
Oh, my God. Okay. So, yeah, man. You give her a fist bump. You see me, I say I should do something. Or say first then. You not try to touch her in a sexual way. Say you have to play like a game with her. Say, you know, you act as if you see something in her ear and say, damn, what's that in your hair, baby? Let me get it for you. You know?
Please.
Boom. And then you act as if you get something for her as well. You know what I mean? I say?
So you playing me?
Nah, please.
You see? Yeah, you gotta be like, yeah.
Man, me just break it, untouchable band, baby. You know what I say? And I kind of make the thing get spicy and sauce up. You know what I say?
Yeah.
Drift, you know, man. So, yeah, man, I don't know if you have, you want to see some bar, you want to move on again.
Yeah, I got a lot to say.
Yeah, man, say something then, man.
So... intimacy doesn't always mean like sex, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. It's other ways that you can touch somebody. But let me just add that sex is good too.
Yeah, man, all the time. All the time.
That's all I got.
All right, then. Man, we say have a lot to say. This is my day, I wait for more. Boy. So, watch out, man. Last one left by my list, you know, man.
Mm-hmm. Final tip.
Last one, brother. You know have to be mysterious. What me say you know have to be? Mysterious.
Mysterious.
Watch your style. You can't talk. You're not a woman go out on the first date again, babe. You see? One heap of talking. You tell your woman everything on the first date. So nothing no dead. For you tell her tomorrow, you're not being mysterious. Mm-hmm. You be a talkative man.
Save some for later.
Then a woman love a mysterious man. Example. Say a woman do like so Katanya. And say, where you from? And you then say, Jamaica.
Mm-hmm.
And she say, where in Jamaica? They say, come mysterious now. You say, maybe I will talk about that the next day, or you ask her, if you want to guess where I'm from in Jamaica. You know what I mean? I say?
Don't tell everything.
Yeah. You have to basically left back something for tomorrow, right, and the next day. You can't just tell everything, gentlemen. You have to be mysterious, man. Where you come from, man? Be mysterious, bro.
It's like when a man will see a woman and they will say to a woman, like, leave something for the imagination. You don't have to be naked or bearing all for everybody to see. Leave something for the imagination. So save some for later.
So when you say, you know, if it be mysterious.
This is not about me. These are your tips.
Okay. Yeah, man. So, yeah, man, that was the last one, being mysterious, family. So, you know, we're there here and... me and Katana just here just relaxing. Maybe we have to go up on the road or what we are going to be able to get some feet and just go all a vibe because soon dinner time and them thing there. So you don't know family with the here and relax. All a normal vibe. So as I say, if you guys like the content, go ahead and share the Bannix content. Drop a like. Drop the comment, family. Drop it. And most important thing, family, watch out, man. Hit the subscribe button.
Subscribe. Come on over and have some fun with the Bannix.
No.
We just holding a vibe and having fun.
Yeah,
so come on, hit that subscribe button.
Hit it, family. So you know what we're there, fam? Until next time,
peace out.